All right, guys, in this week's video, we're gonna be recreating the Bushcraft fishing rod and reel that you might've seen on the History Channel's Alone television show. I built this rod and was able to catch my first fish with it in episode one. So let's get started. The only things that I used on this was a little bit of paracord for the wrapping, some snare wire for the eyelets, and my Leatherman P4 multi-tool. I ended up using this thing a lot while I was out there. So building one of these rods was always a part of my plan. And I actually built several of them before I went out there because I didn't want to be out there trying to figure things out, you know, when things really mattered. I wanted to have everything, like so many of the other skills that I would need out there. I wanted to have things figured out before I hit the ground.
Nice. A big old surf rod.
Now this isn't the exact spool that I had when I was out there at Chilko, but it's pretty similar. And it's actually the only time that I've ever bought fishing line based on the spool itself. I needed something that was wide. I needed something with a fairly low lip on it so that I could cast. And I needed something that was built pretty well because I was going to be using it day in and day out. I wanted to build one of these rods for a couple of different reasons. For one, you can cast a lot farther with a rod like this than you can with just hand line. The second reason is that when you do get a fish on, it's a lot easier to fight that fish and to maintain pressure on that fish with a rod like this versus hand lining. Come on, come on, come on. Trick here is do not let the line slip off of the reel, and that can be a challenge. Because if it slips off the reel, it's going to get around that spindle, and then I'm not going to be able to reel. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Not quite as much at stake today, but I'd still like to catch this fish. That's a little bass. Nice. Oh, yes. Come on. Ha ha. There we go. Nice. When I was out there on the lake, I got this fishing rod done. I immediately put it to good use and put some food on the table. I was very, very pleased with the way it worked. I mean, it couldn't have worked any better. I did have a little bit of trouble, as you saw there in that first episode, when the line came off the spool and wrapped around the spindle. Luckily, I was still able to land that fish just by hand. But after that, I kind of got things figured out a little bit better and actually learned to use the rod and reel. It did take a little bit of trial and error, but I eventually got it figured out. All right, guys, that's going to do it for this video, but we're going to be uploading a new video every week. I might be making stuff. I might be talking about, you know, my experience out there on Chilko Lake. So if you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and do that. Click that little bell icon so you can get notified. With that, remember to subscribe. We'll see you next time.